حمدا طيبا مبارك فيه، نحمده جل وعلا ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونخلع من الحول والقوة إلا إليه، نشكره ولا نكفره، ونخلع ونترك من يفجره، ونشهد شهادة عبد مؤمن أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وخاتم الأنبياء، أنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى على قلبه آيات تتلى منذ ذلك الوقت إلى يوم القيامة. أما بعد، فيا أيها المؤمنون، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله جل وعلا. I praise Allah. I seek His guidance and I seek His forgiveness. And I testify there is no God but Allah, the Almighty, the Creator. And I testify that our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, our leader, our teacher, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose and revealed to his heart the divine revelation. From the time he received it until the day of judgment, we testify that the Prophet conveyed clear from any doubt to all of those they believe in Allah and the Prophet, peace be upon him, as the last Prophet and Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I pray to Allah for continuous blessing unto him, unto his family, unto his companion, unto you until the day of judgment. O believer, I don't say that you are a believer, but Allah, the Almighty, say in the Holy Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called you a believer. So you left this life behind you and you came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You came to remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to learn in this 15-20 minutes that we are with you. Take with you some substance. We call it the fiber of faith and believe. Allah the Almighty revealed to the heart of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, verses that we recite from that day until the day of judgment. Among that, Allah said, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death. And we, as a believer, we have five pillars of faith. I'm not six pillars of faith. Now I'm talking about the five pillars of Islam. Those are two different things. That you believe in the oneness of Allah, the oneness of the message, the oneness of the messenger, and the angel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the day of judgment, and the predestination, good or bad, comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to test us in this life. So I'm not going to talk about the oneness of Allah, because we all are believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe in him. We believe in the message of Islam from Adam until the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We believe in the books that Allah revealed. We believe in the angels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed to all of us. And we know among them Azrael, the angel of death. And we believe that a day will come, and this day is the day of resurrection, يوم القيامة. والإيمان بيوم القيامة هو العدل كله وهو السلام كله وهو الإيمان كله. الإيمان بيوم القيامة, having the faith that the day is going to come, the day of resurrection, the day where all of us will stand before Allah on that divine day of justice. Everyone will harvest the deeds and the reward of his deeds in this life. And Allah said it in Surah Tabarak, تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala glorify himself when he said that glory be God that this dominion is in his hand. He created death and life to test us in this life. Who's among us escaping death? Anyone? The death could happen and occur anytime. No discrimination between gender, religion, or between social status in this life. You have babies, they die. You have women, you have men, you have elderly, you have them in all positions. And before you today, for a week ago, we hear about the passing of the martyr of Muhammad Saeed, who left this life defending his citizen in the city of Malvendale. And today is his burial. He's 26 years old, and he's supposed to defend the law and enforce the peace and protect the citizen. But now he is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one will think about all of these things. Even his chief that I sat with for 3 hours before yesterday, he recited verses from the Holy Quran, learned from Muhammad about Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That we all belong to Allah, and to Him we shall return. And he said, tell me how you cope with death. How? Some until today, as this morning, a man came to my office to say, my dad passed 4 years ago. I cannot get this to go. What shall I do? How we accept that? How we accept the death that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it before life and inform us? I'm not going to talk about just only the revelation, but all mankind. How many thousands of years they left. And Allah said, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَلَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. What's going to happen when this shaking of the earth will happen and all what's inside is going to go? And also, وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ. From Adam until the day that Allah will call this earth and will have the day of resurrection. All of us are going to stand before Allah. And Allah said it in the Holy Quran, clear. Allah يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ. They don't think they are going to come out. So my khutbah today is not because one of our young men passed away. No. My khutbah today, because of these hypocrites in the places of power, they stand to lie about what they did together. Together. They decided all what you've been hearing for 9 months. Not 4 months, but 9 months. They all agreed together. And they listened to this hypocrite who came to say what he said. He did not kill innocent people. How many? How many they get killed? Are you and I, are we thinking about this? Is it this issue is really still in our hearts? And we reject all of those? You have the courage to stand up and remind these people that they are going to die one day. They are going to stand by Allah the Almighty. No one escaped that. All they are going to leave. From the kings to the presidents to the youngest to the oldest, all of them are going to go one day. And we are going to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are going to answer what we did in this life. And let me tell you, the signs of the day of resurrection is coming. There is major signs and there is minor signs. But you and I, Muslims, should be always prepared, Should we always prepare, since we believe that the day is coming? We believe in the hereafter. We believe that we are going to leave this life, this temporary life that we live. Look around us. Don't get busy in this materialistic life, animalistic life. Allah and the Prophet, peace be upon him, explain all of us in detail. And what I'm saying to you is not to discourage you. What I'm saying it to you is to remind myself and to remind you. No matter what we are doing in this life, we always have to dedicate this faith to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be prepared. And when I say prepared, it's not to stand just only in the prayer, but be prepared when you deal and wheel outside in your business. And don't let ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون. Don't wait until that. Don't wait and let this life to really sway you away from what you believe in this life. And don't let anyone affect your faith and belief. Dealing with your family honestly, sincerely, with love and compassion. Dealing with your kids and convey to them the protection that the Prophet, peace be upon him, told us. The honesty, the sincerity, the hard working. All of our kids today, they have different views about religion. Some of them, they believe religion is to have the tobe, to have the beer, and to come and pray. That's it. What they do at home, how to answer their parents, their mom, their dad, their elderly, how to really obtain this knowledge and to be polite about this life. It is very important to us if we are to build a society to be the best and righteous, that what we have to do. It's not enough that they see you and I praying at home, but you have to translate this prayer in action, and the action will be mercy, will be love, will be compassion, will be the right direction to them. Because what they hear, they see it's normal, but this is not normal. We do not accept any, and especially what they are doing today in destruction and killing and all of this. It's happening and unfolding before our eyes, before our ears, before our hearts, before our spirit. And everyone has the devices to go through every minute of our life. So we have to be prepared, and preparation, as I said, with you first, to be honest, sincere, and to admit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be thankful and grateful to whatever He gives you and your family, your kids, your relative, your community, and the community in large. And we are to stand with the righteous deeds in this life. And we can't be this unspoken devil. We cannot be this one. You always have to say the truth. And you stand with the righteous and the righteous things to do today. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in the Quran. To save life is this. Not only Islam, but this is a humanity that Islam came to protect, because Allah said, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ وَحَمَلْنَاهُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Allah honored the children of Adam and gave them the way in the sea and also on land. Death is coming. Are we prepared? Are we really prepared? I'm not saying preparation by having the funeral home agreement and the grave and all of it. I'm saying, are we prepared in deeds? Because when I come to bury someone and lower him down in the grave, alone, nothing, no one with him other than his deeds and your humble prayer, if you stand to pray and remember him. And how long you and I will remember those they pass. How long you do. Your parents, you have to remember them until you go down to meet them. And the rest, how many passed from among us? They used to play with us here. Do you remember them? They used to sit all along this mosque. They left as we are all going to leave. I pray to each and every one of you to have a long life. You may live, you may enjoy, but be righteous. Be righteous. And we have to dedicate time to our own kids to teach them to be a Muslim. Not just Muslim by name, but Muslim by action. Because this life will transform us to do many things. And as you have, and it is a shame to say that when Netanyahu was speaking, you come to our demonstration. How many of you came to this demonstration? None. We did just only a couple of speeches and we went. That how much the value of our people? That is the value of our people in our hearts, mind, and really spirit. We should all stand for humanity. وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَا النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. That's what we have to do. We have to reject all of these munafiqeen. Those hypocrites, they stood up to do what they do. And what is this to be loud and you have everyone clapping, standing. This is the one that you elect. This is the one, if you do not vote, you allow them to really take that seat. So you have to do and exercise your rights because you are going to be asked about it when we go down to our grave brothers and sisters. My dear sister, I remind myself and remind you that the day will come and you and I will have the book to read. اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسابا. So see what you want to write in your book. And I leave you with the saying of our beloved Prophet, peace be upon him, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide our hearts to his guidance. And we have to repent to him. التائب ذنبك من لا ذنب له. ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على من اصطفى سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد فيا أيها المسلمون أوصيكم ونفسي بالتقرب إلى الله وبالنظر في قلوبنا لنرى هل نحن قريبين من رحمة الله أم لا. Let us look in our hearts. Let us renew our faith. Let us see how close are we to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should repent every day before you sleep. As they say, you go to al-mawtatu al-sughra wa huwa al-nawm. That's the last death. As we sleep every night, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask him his forgiveness and ask him to guide our hearts to his guidance. I reminded myself and reminded you. And besides, let us pray to our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command and say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم يا الله يا رحمن السماوات والأرض ورحيمهما. اللهم إنا نجأر إليك بالدعاء أن ترفع الهم والغم وتفك الدماء عن المسلمين أينما كانوا وفي كل أرض حلوا. اللهم لا حول لنا ولا قوة إلا بحولك وقوتك. اللهم يا الله يا رحمن السماوات والأرض ورحيمهما ارحمنا برحمتك واغفر لنا ما قدمنا من أمر أنفسنا. اللهم يا الله ارحمنا وارحم ضعفاء المسلمين في كل مكان من الأرض يا رب العالمين. وارحم إخواننا في غزة وفي السودان وفي سوريا وفي اليمن وفي العراق وفي أفغانستان وفي كل بلاد الدنيا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا الله يا رحمن السماوات والأرض ورحيمهما، هيئ لنا أمر رشد يجمعنا على طاعته يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.